So hello everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIP 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and in today's session I will bring to you five important questions from the PIP news which are very important for ESI section of RBI grade B exam. तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन इफ यू आर न्यू हियर एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द सेशंस. ओके एंड दिस इज गाइस द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. रिसेंटली अ मोबाइल ऐप हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति विच इज हेडेड बाय गजेंद्र सिंह शेखावत. हिज लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इज जोधपुर इन राजस्थान अंडर पीएम किसान सिंचाई योजना for geo tagging. So with the help of which organization the app has been developed. Okay, so ek nayi app develop ki gayi hai under the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana and us app ka hame ye batana hai ki kaun si organization ke help se us app ko develop kiya gaya. Okay, so let us discuss the news first. So this app has been developed for geo tagging. Now what is this geo tagging? So geo tagging mein basically ye hota hai ki एक हम पिक्चर क्लिक कर देते हैं किसी प्रोजेक्ट की और उसको लिंक कर देते हैं विद द लोकेशन. सो जियो टैगिंग का मतलब क्या होता है, वी टेक अ पिक्चर ऑफ एनी प्रोजेक्ट विच इज ऑन गोइंग एंड वी कनेक्टेड विद द लोकेशन ऑफ दिट. ओके, सो दैट इज जियो टैगिंग एंड फॉर दैट जियो टैगिंग दिस ऐप हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड दिस ऐप हैज बीन डेवलप्ड गाइज विद द हेल्प ऑफ भास्कराचार्य नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ स्पेस एप्लीकेशन एंड जियो इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स. ओके, सो रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट. ओके, and this institute guys it is an autonomous scientific society which is registered under the Society Registration Act of 1860 and remember the very important thing that it works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. It does not works under the Ministry of Science and Technology, it works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Okay, so this is a very important information, it can be asked in your exam. All right, and now what are the objectives of the app, why this app has been launched? So first of all hame pata chal gaya ki this app has been developed for the geotagging of the ongoing projects under the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana and with the help of the app we can track the actual status of work and the pace of work. What is the ongoing pace of the work and what is the actual status of the work, we can map this status with the help of this app. And this app can be used to capture the image of the project component along with other details such as location, type of canal, structure, etc. And the captured information can be submitted by the user for geotagging on the geographic information system portal developed for this purpose. Okay, so हम क्या करेंगे, फोटो लेंगे, फोटो के बाद उसके साथ उसकी जो भी लोकेशन है या जो भी और अदर डिटेल्स है वो अटैच करके उसको GIS enabled इस पोर्टल पे हम अपलोड कर देंगे. ओके, सो वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल टेक अ पिक्चर, वी विल टेक अ पिक्चर ऑफ द ऑन गोइंग प्रोजेक्ट अलॉन्ग विद द डिटेल लोकेशन एंड द अदर इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड देन अपलोड इट for the geographic information system portal developed for this purpose. Okay, and this app guys can be operated in both online and offline mode depending on the network connection jahan pe bhi hum photo le rahe hain jahan pe bhi is app ka istemal kar rahe hain. All right, so this was about this news and therefore the correct answer should be what, Bhaskaracharya National Institute of Space Applications and Geo Informatics which is an organization which is a society under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Okay, so therefore option B is the correct answer. Moving on to question number 2. Labor Bureau has recently launched new series of CPI IW. So I hope you must have heard of this new series of CPI IW. So this question is about that only. So let's discuss about this first. So Labor Bureau, which is an attached office of the Ministry of Labor and Employment. So can you tell me the name of Minister of Labor and Employment? Write down in the comments. Who is the Minister of Labor and Employment? So this Labor Bureau has recently launched the new series of CPI IW with the base year 2016. And what is the meaning of IW? I hope aap sabko pata hai, industrial workers. So there are guys 5 types of CPI. We have CPI IW, we have agricultural laborers, we have rural laborers, we have urban CPI urban, and we have CPI rural. So if you want to know in detail about CPI, you can follow the sessions of RBI 24/7. In one of the session of RBI 27, Mansi ma'am has discussed in detail about the CPI. Okay, so this new series has replaced the existing series with a base of 2001 equals to 100. So this can also be asked in your exam guys ki jo naya series aaya hai usne purani wali kaun si series ko replace kiya hai. Okay, the new series has replaced which older series. Okay, and CPI IW is compiled and maintained by the Labor Bureau as I told you. And these are some improvements which we can see in the new series of base year 2016. Like for example, A total of 88 centers have been covered in the 2016 series as compared to the 878 in the earlier series. The number of selected markets for collection of retail price data has also been increased to how much? 317 markets. Or pehle kitna tha? It was 289. Alright. And the number of items has also been increased to 463 items. That is very important. This can be asked in an exam. This data is very, very important. Okay. The number of items has been increased to 463 items as compared to 392 items in the 2001 series. Alright. And the number of states which are now included under the CPI IW is how much? 28, which was earlier how much? 25. Pehle kitne the 25. But now the number of states or UTs which are covered under the CPI IW is increased to 28. Okay. And it gives more weightage now to spending on health, education and recreation rather than food and beverages. Pehle CPI IW mein jo zyada weightage thi, wo kiske upar thi? Food or beverages ke upar. But now the focus has been shifted from food and beverages to health, education and recreation. Recreation matlab development. Alright. So these are some new improvements in the new series. Okay. So this was the question. Identify the correct statements regarding the new series. Okay. So statement one is, in the new series 28 states or UTs are covered. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Earlier they were 25. The number of items has increased to 463. This is also correct. And the number of markets for collection of retail data has been increased to 317. So guys, this statement is also correct, which means all the statements are absolutely correct. Option D will be the correct answer here. And now let's move on to the question number 3, which is again a very important question. So this was the first ever anti-corruption working group meeting of G20 group. Okay. जो G20 ग्रुप है हमारा उसका सबसे पहला एंटी करप्शन वर्किंग ग्रुप मीटिंग हुआ है रिसेंटली वर्चुअली अंडर द प्रेसिडेंसी ऑफ सऊदी अरेबिया. और इस साल जितने भी G20 के समिट होंगे दैट शुड बी अंडर द प्रेसिडेंसी ऑफ सऊदी अरेबिया. दैट विल बी इनफैक्ट बिकॉज दिस ईयर्स G20 प्रेसिडेंसी इज विद सऊदी अरेबिया. तो अगर इस साल आपके सामने 2020 से रिलेटेड अगर कोई क्वेश्चन आता है 2020 में G20 से रिलेटेड अगर कोई क्वेश्चन आता है देन दैट प्रेसिडेंसी विल ओनली बी only with Saudi Arabia. Okay. So G20 anti-corruption working group meeting was recently held virtually under the presidency of Saudi Arabia. So under which summit of G20 this anti-corruption working group meeting was formed? कौन से G20 के summit में ये जो anti-corruption working group meeting था ये form हुआ था. Okay. So let's discuss about this. So इसमें guys जो anti-corruption working group की meeting हुई थी इसमें there is no relevant news for the exam purpose. So इसमें हमें कुछ ज्यादा नहीं पढ़ना but we will discuss about the steps that India has taken towards combating corruption. जो corruption को कम करने के लिए भारतीय सरकार ने जो जो कदम उठाए हैं that we will discuss. And from the Indian side, the representative was Dr. Jitendra Singh. Okay, Dr. Jitendra Singh was the representative from the India side in this meeting. Okay, and these are some guys steps that have been taken by the government of India. So the formation of Central Vigilance Commission is itself a major step towards combating corruption, जो कि हमारे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के ऊपर विजिलेंस रखता है. इट कीप्स विजिलेंस ऑन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन डिपार्टमेंट एंड करंट सेंट्रल विजिलेंस कमिश्नर इज हु? मिस्टर संजय कोठारी. संजय कोठारी इज द करंट सीवीसी चीफ विजिलेंस कमिश्नर, सेंट्रल विजिलेंस कमिश्नर. देन वी हैव प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट ऑफ 1988 अंडर देयर आर वेरियस स्ट्रिंजेंट प्रोविजंस फॉर पनिशमेंट फॉर द करप्शन. ओके. एंड वी हैव लोकपाल एंड लोक आयुक्त एक्ट ऑफ 2013. इट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर a Lokpal and for union and Lok Ayuktas for the states. And the first ever Lokpal was who? Pinaki Chandra Ghosh. Pinaki Chandra Ghosh is the first ever Lokpal of our country. And this act brings in more transparency, more citizen centricity and accountability in the governance. Then we have Fugitive Economic Offenders Act 2018. Agar koi paise leke bhag jata hai, if there is a fugitive, then that person will be booked under this act, Fugitive Economic Offenders Act of 2018. And then we have Prevention of Money Laundering Act of 2002. And of course, guys, these facts, okay, ye jo humne abhi padha, India's step towards combating corruption, these facts will not come in our exam directly in the MCQ format, but you can use this format, you use this information in your essay portion, alright? And if we talk about briefly about this G20 anti-corruption working group, so it was set up in 2010 at the Toronto Summit of G20. And it has an objective to prepare comprehensive recommendations for consideration by leaders on how the G20 could continue to make practical and valuable contributions to international efforts to combat corruption. ये basically ये जो पूरी line है ये इनके objective में से मैंने copy करी है. Basic जो इसका मतलब है वो सिर्फ यही है कि जो G20 member countries है वहां पे हमारी corruption कम करने के लिए क्या क्या steps लेने हैं, that we have to discuss with the all the G20 member nations. Okay. So this is the basic objective, and it was, remember this, this is very important. It was set up in 2010 at the Toronto Summit of G20. Okay. So now let's come to the question. Question is, under which summit of G20 this anti-corruption working group meeting was formed? So this was, guys, Toronto Summit in the year 2010. So option C will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to the question number 4. Name the portal which was recently launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. He is also the Minister for Civil Aviation. To integrate legacy drawings such as maps and lease plans in the management information system and make it GIS enabled. So there is an app that has been launched by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs that ताकि जो जितने भी हमारे मैप्स हैं और जो लीज प्लान्स हैं उनको इंटीग्रेट किया जा सके विद द मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम, सो दैट वी कैन इंटीग्रेट अवर ऑल द लेगेसी मैप्स विद द मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम एंड मेकिंग देम जीआईएस एनेबल्ड, ताकि हमारा जो जीआईएस है उससे वो कनेक्ट हो सके एंड उसकी प्रॉपर इंफॉर्मेशन हमारे पास हो. एंड द नेम ऑफ द ऐप गाइज इज व्हाट, ई धरती. ऑप्शन ई सी, ई धरती इज द करेक्ट आंसर है. एंड इसके बारे में हमें ज्यादा डिटेल में पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. इफ एनी क्वेश्चन कम्स इन योर एग्जाम देन it will be about the name of the app only, or it can be asked that which ministry has launched this e dharti app. So remember, the ministry is what? Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Okay, so this was question number 4, and now let's talk about the question number 5, which is a very important question because ye directly ek day se relate karta hai, and that day is about the social issue in our country. So the National Deworming Day. ओके, ये नेशनल डिवॉर्मिंग डे के बारे में, एंड व्हाई वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट दिस नेशनल डिवॉर्मिंग डे आई विल टेल यू लेटर. सो दिस डे वाज स्टार्टेड इन 2015 टू इरैडिकेट इंटेस्टिनल वॉर्म्स व्हिच इज आल्सो नोन एज सॉइल ट्रांसमिटेड हेलमिंथ्स अमंग चिल्ड्रन इन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 1 टू 19 इयर्स व्हिच डेट्स आर ऑब्जर्व्ड एज नेशनल डिवॉर्मिंग डे. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग गाइस अबाउट नेशनल डिवॉर्मिंग डे बिकॉज रिसेंटली Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has stated that 14 states in our country have shown decline in the cases of intestinal worms among the children. Okay, बच्चों के अंदर intestinal worms के जो cases हैं, उससे होने वाली जो बीमारियां हैं, उसका जो prevalence है, वो कम हुआ है in the 14 states of our country, as stated by the Ministry of Housing and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Okay, so that is why we are discussing about this National Deworming Day. And if you talk about this in more detail, so National Deworming Day, it was started, guys, in 2015. And the question mein hume objective pata hai, that is, was this day was started to eradicate intestinal worms, which is also known as soil transmitted helminths, which which causes the infections in the intestines of children. Okay, and every year 10th of February and 10th of August, 10th of February and 10th of August is observed as the National Deworming Day. And this day is observed in collaboration with Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Women and Child Development, and the Ministry of Education. Okay, Ministry of Women and Child Development or Ministry of Education के साथ collaboration में इस day को observe किया जाता है. और होता क्या है इस दिन? होता ये है कि जितने भी children हैं, जितने भी adolescents हैं, जितने भी चिल्ड्रन और जितने भी एडोलेसेंट्स हैं इन ऑल द गवर्नमेंट एंड ऑल द गवर्नमेंट एडेड स्कूल एंड इन द आंगनवाड़ी सेंटर्स, उन सभी जगह पे इन सभी बच्चों को और एडोलेसेंट्स को एल्बेंडाजोल नाम की टैबलेट दी जाती है, दैट इज फॉर क्योरिंग ऑफ वॉर्मिंग इंटेस्टिनल वॉर्म. ओके, एल्बेंडाजोल नाम की टैबलेट दी जाती है टू ऑल द चिल्ड्रन एंड एडोलेसेंट्स ऑन दिस डे. And this day is observed every year on 10th of Feb and 10th of August, starting from 2015. Started by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and it is observed in collaboration with Ministry of Women and Child Development and the Ministry of Education. Okay, so the question is, which dates are observed as National Deworming Days? So the dates are, guys, 10th February and 10th August, which mean option C will be the correct answer. Okay guys, so that's it for the session. I hope आपको ये session अच्छा लगा, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Guys, कुछ लोगों ने पूछा था कि क्या हमें PIB पढ़ने की जरूरत है after watching your sessions. So guys, if you are preparing for ESI RBI grade B, then for ESI section you don't have to study PIB, okay? Because PIB pura ka pura ESI section ke liye I am covering. So keep watching this session. You can just watch this session and make notes out of it. Then ESI section aapka pura ka pura, agar PIB mein se kuch hai, to wo cover ho jayega, okay? Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.